Hello and welcome to September's Flix Flix, the film and event magazine programme brought to you by Picture House Cinemas. My name's Flick and coming up on this month's show, Before I Go to Sleep, psychological thriller from writer-director Rowan Joffe, A Most Wanted Man, Le Carré spy thriller and Philip Seymour Hoffman's last film, 20,000 Days on Earth, fact and fiction mesh in Nick Cave's magnificent documentary, Map to the Stars, Hollywood satire meets ghost story a la David Cronenberg, and Flix Picks, my roundup of screenings and events across the group. Before I Go to Sleep is directed by Rowan Joffe, Brighton Rock, and adapted from the best-selling novel by S.J. Watson. Starring Nicole Kidman and Colin Firth as a North London suburban husband and wife, or are they? Apparently Kidman has suffered an horrific accident, leaving her unable to remember anything when she wakes up every morning. She is reminded daily with photos and notes around the house, and her husband seemingly having to repeat the events leading up to today daily. A great cast, including Mark Strong as Kidman's therapist, and excellent script make this a taut, gripping, completely immersing thriller.
What are you hiding from me?
You want the truth? I'll tell you the truth!
Hello, it's Dr. Nash.
I'm your husband, Ben.
You won't remember me. Your imagination is filling in the gaps.
Don't trust anyone. Whatever happened that night, whatever I've done, I have to remember.
A Most Wanted Man is directed by Anton Corbijn, Control the American, and stars Philip Seymour Hoffman as a German intelligence officer based in Hamburg shortly after 9/11. I have to quote John le Carré, who didn't actually think him right for the role. He says, gradually, he did what only the greatest actors can do. He made his voice the only authentic one, the lonely one, the odd one out, the one you depended on amid all the others. Needless to say, the film becomes focused around Hoffman's character, despite him not being the wanted man in question. A beautiful, melancholy, atmospheric thriller that beggars the question, is all we do in the name of freedom worth it?
I'm not doing this for you.
Your choice is between us and nobody. The clock is ticking. All I'm asking for is more time.
And if this kid lets off a bomb?
Every good man has a little bit of bad, doesn't he? But that little bit just might kill you.
We can't undo what's done. There's no going back for any of us.
"20,000 Days on Earth" was described as arguably the most exciting film in competition at this year's Sundance, where it won Best Director and was a Grand Jury Prize nominee. It presents as both drama and documentary, a truly unique presentation of truthful insight into an extraordinary artist mixed with his fictitious 20,000th day on Earth. Shockingly candid and yet stealthily enigmatic, how much is really given away? Who knows? What is true without a doubt is that this is a subtle and beautiful unearthing of the creative process. Dark, hilarious, frightening, and utterly compelling.
Should we stop there?
I'm transforming. I'm vibrating. I'm glowing. I'm flying.
This shimmering space where imagination and reality intersect, where all love and tears and joy exist. This is the place. This is where we live.
I had to speed read your biography.
Oh, you read that thing?
Yeah.
That wasn't the truth, though.
Map to the Stars is a less than affectionate, darkly humorous satire slash ghost story from director David Cronenberg, most famous for bizarre horror such as The Fly and Dead Ringers. it's his strangest film yet, Cronenberg has assembled an A-list Hollywood cast to deliver his subversive message. John Cusack, Julianne Moore, Mia Wasikowska, Robert Pattinson and Evan Bird are all well selected to play monsters of sorts, driven by ambition, ruled by neurosis, ego and paranoia, and all watched over by the Hollywood sign.
Na 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 na, hey hey hey, goodbye. Come on, sing it!
On the forehead of my friends, on every hand held out, I write your name.
It's about your sister. I think she may be back.
I think you're a little crazy.
So?
Am I better looking than her?
You want that role, but you're not gonna get it.
It was like a dream.
I'm alive, and I'm not crazy!
On the stairs of death, I write your name. Liberty.
And now FlixPix, my roundup of screenings and events across the group. On Wednesday the 3rd of September, Simon Godwin makes his RSC directorial debut with Shakespeare's exuberant and romantic comedy Two Gentlemen of Verona. This is the first time in 45 years the play has been performed in full production on the Royal Shakespeare Theatre stage. On the 4th, Helen McCrory returns to the National Theatre to take the lead role in Medea, in Ben Powers' new version of Euripides' powerful tragedy, directed by Carrie Cracknell. Facing banishment and separation from her children, Medea exacts an appalling revenge and destroys everything she holds dear. As I previewed last month, Gillian Anderson plays Blanche Dubois in the highly acclaimed sellout production of Tennessee Williams' timeless masterpiece, A Streetcar Named Desire, screening live on the 16th from the Young Vic. Based on the Oscar-nominated film, Billy Elliot has been dazzling London's West End since 2005, winning more than 80 awards and captivating audiences around the world. With music by Elton John, sensational dancing and a powerful storyline, this is an astonishing, unforgettable theatre experience. Catch it live on your Picture House cinema screen on the 28th. On the 30th, a treat for all you old new romantics out there. George Henken's much anticipated biopic of one of the 80s most flamboyant yet commercially successful bands, Spandau Ballet. Soul Boys of the Western World lets the band directly recount their rise from working-class Islington roots to the excesses of champagne, cocaine and adrenaline which preceded, if not ultimately caused, their demise in 1990. The screening will be followed by a special live concert via satellite by Spandau Ballet at the Royal Albert Hall. Finally, on the 1st of October, don't miss a rare opportunity to see the multi-award-winning comedian, actor, presenter, writer and raconteur, Stephen Fry, giving a one-man comic tour de force. This special event marks the publication of Stephen Fry's brand new volume of memoirs, More Fool Me, and will be broadcast live around the world. That's it for September. Remember to check out our website, picturehouses.co.uk, for more information on these and other upcoming films and events. Our free Picture House Recommends magazine is available at your local Picture House venue or as an iPad app. Thank you for watching and see you again next month.